It is honest to say that Martin Litton, a newspaper reporter from California turned river rat and later Sierra Club board member, defeated, through his disdain for compromise, the building of two dams that many government officials had their minds set on erecting in the heart of Grand Canyon. One of the ways Litton thwarted the flooding of the cathedral, as some now call the dam building effort, was by taking people down the river. And no one took people down the river quite as reverently and elegantly as Litton. He founded the outfitting company Grand Canyon Dories in 1969, which, through the company oars, continues to this day. A dory is a decked wooden boat, quite possibly the most beautiful vessel to have ever encountered moving water. I can tell you that to witness such a boat on the Grand Canyon is a thrill. To ride on one's back through the canyon must be akin to perfection. Litton named each dory for a natural wonder destroyed by man, and many of his early boats bore names of places drowned by the construction of Glen Canyon Dam: the Hidden Passage, the Tapestry Wall, the Dark Canyon, and the Tickaboo. Litton died in 2014 at age 97. His obituary in the Los Angeles Times noted that he rode through the Grand Canyon, enjoyed a stiff drink, and piloted his vintage Cessna into his 90s. It is hard to say aloud, but if not for Litton, we may not have dories. It is harder yet to say that the Grand Canyon itself, blocked behind the once proposed Marble and Bridge Canyon dams, might well have been drowned if it weren't for the thundering presence of Litton, who once noted, quote, "Nature has its rights. It has a right to be here, untrammeled, unfettered. Man doesn't have to screw everything up," end quote.